The body is more interesting than a stone because it's got a mind in it. Maybe more importantly, the body is of interest because we live inside it rather than all the other things that we have to observe from the outside.
这边是牙齿，这种是脑啊，都是脑部，但是很对对头部分，大脑、小脑、眼脑都在那边，但是等下再喝一点，但是因为脚底它必须要排毒。嗯，我们台湾有盲人学校嘛，我还有一个小孩子，现在还在后里勤学校读书，嘿，他现在也是在学按摩，在学校里面都。 他们的教会家的按摩，你家女儿、儿子，都看不到，嘿，肝、眼睛、耳朵，都这两只，嗯哼，好，脑部、牙齿，这大部分，坐骨神经。
History of life, but also maybe its challenge to us is that we all come out of other bodies. Our bodies come out of other bodies. So in a sense, our primary experience is of dwelling within the realm of another, within, in a way, the protection of another body as our primary habitation. So we learn how to listen, how to move, how, in a way, to attend to the world within a totally protected realm. And then at birth, that is taken away from us. We are made into an object, where we might recover something of that primal condition. But on the whole, you know, we are born alone and we die alone, and in a sense that is the human condition, that we are lost in space. You could think of this child sleeping on the breast or the stomach of the mother, in a way, close to the place where the child grew in the womb. And for many people, that's very shocking. This very small object that is very evidently human, that I often show it alone in a big room. But people have become very emotional in relationship to it.
So, yeah, this is me just bunched up like that in a crouched position, and I'm basically covered in cling film, and then covered in plaster and scrim. With something like this, it's just, you can imagine this was quite tight, so I had to be bound together to hold that for that meant length of time.
those years of intense meditation remain the foundation of my work, because it was the opening of the door of a new kind of knowledge, using the conditions of existence as a kind of test site for asking questions about what it means to be alive, what it means to be conscious. Looking at the body not as an image, not as an icon to be used for its symbolic or narrative purposes, but the body as a place, an open place, a place of inquiry and exploration.
敏感度比较强，好，这边是你的太阳穴，因为毕竟盲人眼睛不好嘛，啊，他都是我们都是靠手啊的感应比较强啊，啊，所以说盲人我们台湾现在目前是盲人才有按摩执照，像我们这个脑部的话，太阳穴脑部的话，它是肩膀以上，肩膀像是交叉的。
哎，这是这一脚管那一脚，那一脚就管这一脚这边的。
这边管那边，这边的话要管那边。啊，如果说肩膀以下，这是这边以下的话，就是平面下来的，这边就管这边，那边这边就管这边，啊，这是脑部这边就是交叉。
就会明显，因为左侧躺的话，心脏会比较贴近胸壁。嗯。然后这个时候，就用手去触，感觉到它的那个心脏大脑的话，就是可以用叩诊的方式去做，就是去找到那个，因为。
他的也是死因，不会像是那个肺部。因为我觉得我的心地很软，然后之后我很喜欢帮助别人，而且我想在第一线就可以去帮助别人，然后就可以去接触病人，然后帮助更多人。我觉得医生当一个好医生是可以帮我实现这个愿望。最主要是，当重点是当医学院开始的时候，我们正言法师。 他最主要是希望能够这个医学院能够为我们的医院培养好的医生，视病如亲的医生，是一个能够是一个良医，而不是一个名医，是人心人术的良医。
最后一次凝视小珍老师的睡颜，替老师身体盖上白布。 秘密的包扎，想着这学期一路走来有挫折、沮丧、自责、难过等负面情绪袭来，压到喘不过气，常常觉得对不起小珍老师，因为自己不够努力，让老师身上多了刀痕或是找不到老师的神经血管。这时总会发着呆，静静握着小珍老师的手掌，依稀可以感到一股力量，似乎是小珍老师您对我说。
没关系，不要心急，慢慢来。那中国人不愿意捐大体的原因，就是中国人孔子的思想，就是身体发肤受之父母，不可毁伤。设立起来最大的困难就是如何得到捐赠的大体。但是慈济要盖医学院，他要。 最主要的目的是要把慈济的人文，也就是感恩、尊重、爱，放到这个大体解剖这个 class
里面。进到这里，然后这边会有吧台，都是放着我们的大体老师。
然后进来这边，大体老师就会放，就会安静的躺在上面，然后我们会先默祷一分钟，然后默祷完之后，我们会看到上面的那个照片，上面，就是这电视上面会放着大体老师的生平简介，然后还有老师的照片。 第一次进来的时候，我们这边有一个举办一个小小的那个仪式，感恩仪式，就是大体老师的启用仪式。然后所有的家属都会围在旁边，然后他们当他们把那个白布掀开，看到大体老师的时候，所有的人都跪下来，所有的大家都跪下来，然后都边哭，然后我们就默默在旁边看着，那真的是非常感人。然后我们会觉得非常的于心不忍，因为他我们就要即将在他们的家属上面动刀，然后整排的那个手术台旁边，大家都跪下，然后那边哭。
其实，尊重跟爱是同样是一种 feeling 的问题，是一种感觉的问题。所以，当跟我们接触的，不管是 useless body， 或是他的 family， 或者他的那个朋友，他们看到我们对待 donor 的态度，哦。 就可以感受到我们对他的 care 跟 love 跟 respect。但这种 care respect 不是用话能够讲出来了，是一种非常 inside 的 warm 的 feeling，那不是用言语可以，那只有从这个过程中，你进去这个过程，你的 family， 你的 friend， 或者 even body himself， 就是 useless body himself can feel， if he still have the spiritual inside in the body， 所以这个 respect 是很难去形容的，是一种 feeling 的问题，是一种 soul 的问题。
进来这里就是用手术的时候，看到家属在旁边，你有什么感受？就是我真的觉得非常的罪恶感。我觉得我凭什么？我只是一个学生，我凭什么可以做？就是可以在一个人的身上做一些手术的动作？我何德何能？然后就是第一次的时候是一直哭，一直哭，一直哭，然后情绪很激动，根本就是手是颤抖的。然后我就觉得我一定要好好的做。然后。
最主要是他学生去访问家庭的时候，可以看到他们这个家庭每一个成员都对亡者的不舍，跟爱，跟关怀。那在中国传统社会里面，其实，捐大体是一个很不敬的事情，对那个长辈。 所以他们能够，虽然是已经同意，但是心中有很多不舍跟不忍。那在这里面，那个同学就会感受到，如果他是我的爸爸妈妈的话，对不对？那我要怎么，对不对？敢去面对他，对不对？所以这份情就开始产生了，这种情产生就会产生他的那个 respect。 所以当他回来的时候，就晓得哦，他不是一个 useless body， 或者是一个 material 而已，他是一个有血有肉，愿意为了我们医学院的学生牺牲他自己。这边就是我们存放新进的大体老师的地方。
那这些大体老师，他们放在这种很光亮的地方，他们不会放在像其他医院一样，或者是其他学校一样放在地下室，他们就让他们。 就是每一个都可以安静的静养在这边休息。然后这些新的大体老师，他们每一个人都有名字贴在这边，这样子让家属的话都可以来观瞻他们的遗容。那他就是他们就放在这边这样，而且很光亮。然后这些大体老师其实他都是将来大概要3-5年之后的那些医学生才会用到的。所以像我们在做大体的时候，我们的老师其实都已经在里面等很久了，就是在我们还没入学之前，他们就进来了。
所以重点是因为我是在佛教家庭，所以从小就接触佛法。那佛法其实它的宗旨就是以上人来说是大爱。那佛教那时候当初讲的是慈悲喜舍，那要做到慈悲喜舍呢，先要做到六度，就是刚刚我们讲的布施、持戒、忍辱、精进、禅定跟智慧。那如果经过这个六度之后呢，我们才能够到达菩萨或者佛的境界。好，那这个看起来是很容易，慈悲喜舍是外显的，但是内一定要做到刚刚讲的布施、持戒、忍辱、精进那些六个。那重点的是我来到慈济大学参加这个 program 之后才有这个 idea， 说我想要懂这个。因为我是佛教徒，布施里面其实有三种布施，一个是物质的布施，一个是法布施，一个是无畏施。无畏施就是把身体捐出来。
That's maybe where I'm going now in my evocation of the body, and maybe something to do with my age and the fact that I'm very conscious now of things breaking down, of, in a way, me being, in terms of my life journey, in the second half of my life, and wanting to accept this thing, that this aggregate of carbon that, you know, all of the atoms of which originated somewhere out there in an expanded universe are going to be, in a way, taken back into the circulation of mass and energy that is the physical conditions of our existence. I find that very, you know, it isn't frightening, it isn't, and maybe as a result of meditation, I find that not frightening. I think it's a rather comforting thing to think that this temporary aggregate of mind and matter that constitutes a human, a precious human birth, you know, it's a bit like surfing. We do it while we can, and then the wave goes back into the sea. Maybe that's an image of a Buddhist notion of incarnation, and that actually lives and forms the whole rising and disappearing of lives and forms is a kind of endless mystery. Eliot said, where is the knowledge we have lost? No, where is the understanding we have lost in knowledge? Knowledge suggests always defined quantities, and uh, understanding suggests that you might not, that it's a process that is open-ended. The whole idea about the rational, the kind of Cartesian inevitability of the empiric. And I think if we replace that word with understanding, we recognize that there may be other ways of using human consciousness that are not necessarily about getting advantage. In the empirical tradition of, I suppose, Western knowledge, and the way in the 18th century with de Kuyp and lots of you Dutch chaps who were very, very keen on anatomy as the new, in a way, terra incognita, becoming pioneers of a kind of colonization of the territory of the body, finding its great rivers, its hidden continents. I mean, this is a fascinating, if you like, physical landscape, but I'm not interested in that, really. The notion of, as it were, the empirical study of the body as a machine, that I think was very, very much part of the Enlightenment project, I think blinded us to other aspects of embodiment.
这段等待老师在被让我们医学生那个练习的时候，这段时间你们觉得心情会不会很难熬，或者是
？OK， 这好问题啊、因为依照佛教来讲，他遗体人走了，只是躯壳在这边，但是他的灵魂已经不在了，但是我们也会想念他，但是我希望说我把他的精神放在我的心里里面，因为主要是人心的问题，我希望他放在我的心里里面，但是我不要执着这个遗体，因为这个遗体，这个佛教所谓的成住坏空的问题，他今天的遗体哪天也是会坏掉，像我也会哪天我也会老，我也会死掉，但是我能执着什么东西？我不能执着，对，所以我们等待这四年的时候，我自己去心情去调试很多东西。我因为这段时间，我必须要把自己放得很平静，我不能因为妈妈过世，我什么事情都不能做。对，我以前对我很怕，我本身很怕死的，我以前在医院实习的时候，只要任何病人过世，我都会心情很复杂。可是我第一次发现说死亡这么接近的是我亲人的时候，对，然后我才知道说那个什么叫做死亡。对，
那佛教就是让这个人从身体 开始释放出自由，然后灵魂也释放出自由。那当身体释放自由的时候，其实那个肉体已经不是我们想象的肉体，肉体是一个四大和合的一个假象，任何有形的物质都是四大和合的假象。所以这个捐赠是一种不过是一种表现出形象上的一个法，但是事实上讲那个一点，就是说它是一种爱的表现而已。
我们把这封信就是大家写好之后，每个人亲手放到老师的那个棺材棺木上面，而且是棺木里面，而且是放在老师的头的旁边，就希望老师在天上可以看到。缝下最后一针，小珍老师已恢复最初的模样，安静而安详。回想当初踏入大体实习室，我们怀着紧张的心，颤抖的手，在老师胸腔划下第一刀，这学期的学习就此展开，几乎天天与小珍老师您相伴。老师，您默默的教导，静静的指引我们理解复杂的神经肌肉血管，让我们渐渐能够与医学接轨。这个就是我们的大体老师小珍老师，这就是他存放他的骨灰的地方，就当他火化的时候剩下一些些那个骨灰，然后我们就把它放到这里面，然后存放。
I think we must now decide which...
I know, how are we going to get you out?
Along the gap between my thighs and my chest.
I think of the process as being one of a kind of transfer of concentration, that you just have to be. It's very important to me that this is... All of the work is about being, not about action, not about a frozen moment in a narrative of action. It's about being, not doing. And meditation helps enormously in that concentrated attention to being. Once you accept this condition of stillness and silence, that the mind becomes incredibly free. I mean, you are alert, aware, but all of those normal, in a way, instruments of direct action, walking or making, doing things, having an effect on the world, are taken away. And that's like the biggest holiday you can ever have, because the mind can go everywhere when the body is really still. In meditation, that's one of the things you should try to stop. but when you're being molded, it's a marvelous feeling of this, in a way, expansion of the mind. The Tibetans call them, you know, the sky nature of mind, and I think that is the nature of mind. Our minds want to wander. Well, they want to expand. They want to be limitless.
Wilt u naar aanleiding van deze uitzending reageren of een gratis programmagids bestellen? Bezoek dan onze website boeddhistischeomroep.nl. DVD's van onze programma's kunt u bestellen op 010 411 3977.